Continuing number 4B from part 1 of this video, we were just about to do our OR probability, which is adding the probabilities and then subtracting the overlap. So we're adding the breakfast probability plus the probability that they rated the services poor, and then subtracting the overlap, which was the 5 people that fit both categories, so 5 out of 160. That gives us 25 plus 45 minus 5 would be 65 out of 160, which divides to 65 divided by 160 is 0.40625, rounded to 0.406. Part C and D have our new word given, conditional probability. That word will restrict the sample space to only the given set. What is the given set in Part C? It always comes after the word given. I need to look there first. We kind of read these problems backwards because we can't find the first part until we know what the sample space is, and we need the second part to know how to restrict the sample space. So in Part C, the given set, looking after the word given, is that the meal was dinner. That restricts my sample space to only the dinner row. That's my sample space. I don't want anything else in this chart. So I would suggest you physically block out the rest of the chart. We only want to look at the dinner row. So I've taken out everything else in the chart and just left the part that I want to look at. The total of the dinner row, 70, is our denominator because that's the total of our restricted sample space. The question asked the probability that they rated the service poor, but we're only looking in the dinner row. So in the dinner row, that number that said that the service was poor was 25. So that's our probability, is 25 over 70. And let's get a decimal form on the calculator. 25 divided by 70 is 0.35714, or 3.357, rounded to 3 decimal places. Part D, looking after the word given, we see that the given set is that the service was rated as poor. So that is our sample space, the service poor column. Cover up everything else. We only want numbers from the service poor column. The total of that column is 45. So that's the denominator of our probability. We want the probability the person ate dinner, given that the service was rated as poor. So we want the probability that the number that ate dinner, but only in the service poor column. So the number in that column that ate dinner was 25. So our numerator is 25. And that equals 0.5555 repeating, so rounded to 3, it's 0.056. Conditional probabilities are what we use if we want to look at subgroups. For example, how might the manager of this restaurant use the information, say in part C? Well, the given set there was dinner. So she might have found that probability if she wanted to evaluate the dinner staff. Well, what she's discovered is that this proportion, and in percent form that would be almost 36%, of patrons eating dinner rated the service as poor. Is that acceptable? Have 36% of your customers be unhappy? Maybe she'll have a talk with the staff. Part D separated out the patrons that rated the service as poor, looking at everyone who said the service was poor. Here, the manager might just want to look overall at the staff that is doing a poor job. Who are they? What time are they working? Well, who gets the worst ratings out of the staff? Well, over half, 0.556 would be over half of the patrons who said that they got poor service were there for dinner. So it looks like dinner patrons seem to be more dissatisfied than the breakfast and lunch patrons. Why? Well, maybe dinner patrons have higher expectations, or maybe the dinner staff just isn't doing as good of a job as lunch and breakfast. Something the manager might want to look into more.